Here is a class A, two interfaces, and a class B that extends A and implements the two interfaces. We show you what an object of class B looks like in two steps. First, we draw classes B, A, and object, showing not the full partitions as we have been doing, but only their names. Second, since B implements C1, we draw a new line from B upward to C1. And the same for C2. Now let's talk about casting. We show a variable B that contains a pointer to the object. This object can be cast to any of the classes and interfaces that you see in the object, in any order, and to nothing else. For example, B can be cast to A, then to C1, and then the result can be stored in variable H. Java does upward cast automatically, as you know, but downward or sideways casts have to be done explicitly. What method calls like h.m paren close paren are legal? Variable h has a C1 perspective. The Java rule, as you know, is that m must be declared in C1. If not, the call is syntactically illegal, and the program will not compile. The call h.equals is legal. Remember that for each method in class object, if it is not redeclared in C1, Java inserts it into C1 automatically as an abstract method. Suppose m paren dot 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 paren is syntactically legal. Which m will be called at runtime? What one is called? Well, use the overriding rule. Look first in B, then A, then object. Interfaces may appear more than once in an object. You can skip this part and come back to it when you are more at ease with interfaces. Let's add a new interface, C3, and a new class, D. Note that interface C3 extends interface C1. To the right, we draw an object of class D, as well as a variable that points to it. Interface C1 appears twice in the object. If we cast D to C1, which C1 is meant? Well, it doesn't matter. First, the same methods M are available from both perspectives. Second, the overriding method is the same in both, the one in class D. In fact, it would be okay to have just one partition for C1 in the hierarchy with an upward line from each class or interface that extends it.